Today in the G1000 simulator, we're going to demonstrate three ways you can intercept an airway off an ATC assigned heading. The first method will be using conventional VOR navigation on the green needles, Nav1. Second method, we'll be using the FMS and the Direct2 function where we can set a course for the bearing to the VOR that the airway uses. And the third method will be programming the FMS to insert that leg of the airway in and then fly it. Each of these methods has advantages and disadvantages. We'll go through those as we demonstrate. In this scenario, where you've taken off on an assigned heading, we have just checked on with departure. They've given us a climb up to our final altitude, and the next call we're simulating here would be to fly heading 090 and intercept Victor 34. Victor 34 here on the en route chart, you can see comes out of Hancock on the 313 radial or 133 bearing to Hancock. And now we'll unpause the sim and we'll fly that clearance using the conventional navigation, your green needles or Nav1 on the G1000. So in the climb, and we've just gotten a clearance from ATC to fly heading 090, intercept Victor 34, as we just briefed. So I'm gonna do this on green needles, and to switch to green needles, I'm gonna hit my CDI button, and there's VOR1, and use the course knob to center it up first by pushing, and then I'll set my 133 bearing to the station. And finally, push nav on the AFCS mode control panel. And you can see VOR is armed and we're still flying that 090, put the right heading in there, 090 heading to intercept the airway. And as you remember probably from your training, when we're going to intercept a radial from a VOR from top to bottom, we're gonna be flying to the VOR. So from top to bottom to the VOR, our radial's in the bottom of the case. And you can see that the needle is coming in, one dot deflection. Now, the disadvantage to using green needles is that, or conventional navigation on the G1000, as we get closer to the VOR, we're gonna enter the cone of confusion here, and or we're gonna lose VOR guidance, so we'll have to switch to heading mode anyways, but we also need to change our flight guidance mode. So I'm gonna center my heading bug, push heading, and now I'm gonna switch my CDI mode back to GPS, and we'll wait till we cross the station and our next leg becomes active on the flight plan. And there we go, and now I can hit our next leg became active. I'm gonna push nav, and now it's gonna switch to GPS navigation crossing Hancock. That's a little bit busier than if we altered the flight plan in the GPS to intercept that airway. We'll show you that next. In this scenario, we're gonna use the FMS Direct2 function and the course function on that Direct2 menu to set in the bearing to the VOR. Once again, we just got that clearance, turn heading 090, intercept Victor 34. So 090 heading, and on my en route chart here, I can see that 313 radial off of Hancock. As we discussed, I'm gonna go direct to Hancock and use my FMS scroll wheel, the big knob, to come down to course to set that to, as we discussed before, 133. Enter and activate. That's gonna draw a line out of Hancock, you can see there. And I'm gonna push nav, and you can see now GPS is lit up in white or armed in the AFCS status box with heading still active on that 90 heading assigned by ATC. And there's an intercept using the course function on the direct to menu to select the bearing to the VOR that matches the airway. The advantage to using this method is there's now nothing to do as we cross Hancock. We'll just fly right over it and intercept our original flight plan as it was already entered in the FMS. So the last method that we can use to intercept an airway is by programming the leg into the FMS, altering the flight plan. This is going to take the most button pushing or clicking, if you will, but it's the least prone to human error because we don't have to do math figuring out converting a radial to a bearing to the VOR. In this case, on the en route chart here, if I look at Victor 34 coming off Hancock, which is Hotel November Kilo, the intersection prior to Hancock is Pataki. So what I'll do in this case is, now that we've got the heading from ATC of 090 to intercept Victor 34, is I'll go back on my en route chart to Pataki, use the FMS cursor knob, push, and above Hancock, I'm going to enter Pataki, which is Papa Tango Alpha Kilo India, and monitoring my PFD while I enter Pataki. Looks good, PFD, enter. Now I have to activate that leg. So with Hancock highlighted, I'll push menu, activate leg, enter, and yes, Pataki to Hancock, activate, enter. And now I'll have to push the nav button on the AFCS mode control panel, which gives us GPS guidance is armed, so we'll intercept that airway using GPS guidance. Still on our 090 heading to intercept. Now let's watch the airplane fly that. And GPS mode is capturing. I'll swing my heading around. That's 6,000 climbing for 7,000. And GPS mode captured. And you can see we're captured on that course. Now, the advantage to this method of altering the flight plan is, as I said, there's the least chance for human error, because as long as we spell that intersection right and we can verify that off our chart, if it just makes logical sense. Now, the advantage to altering the flight plan and activating that leg to intercept the airway is there's the minimizing the risk for human error there. We don't have to do math reversing a radial for a bearing to the station. If you have questions about the G1000 or the Garmin automated flight control system, please leave a comment below.